This is the first time I've heard this song in church.
That's me, by the way.
A song about a bar. I guess that's... There's a sermon in there somewhere. Well, this is the day the Lord has made. Amen. Good to see all y'all here today. Or would y'all, is it you guys up here? Is it, I just, whatever. All y'all. It's great to see all y'all here today. Got a few announcements. Sunday school starts next week. So if you know of any children, bring them for Sunday school next week. Come here first and then go during the worship hour. Woodsville is having their church bazaar on Saturday, September 30th. It's going to be open from 9 to 2. They have crafts, bake and food sale, silent auction, white elephants, and if you want to donate anything, call Paula House. I'm sure will take anything over at Woodsville. The deck and ramp rebuild project has been postponed, so probably till the spring. But we are going to do the plexiglass on the windows before winter. So pay attention to the announcements on that. And if you want to participate in the Redbird mission or find more about it, talk to David Adams. He's the guy with all the info. Are there any other announcements I need to make this morning? Yes.
UMW has a district meeting coming up, and it's all the churches in New Hampshire. And that is October 7th, and it's going to be down in the Lebanon Church. And we're trying to raise funds to help a church in Vermont, and it's in Montpelier, Vermont. They lost their food pantry and everything that was down in the bottom, and so we are trying to help that. All churches are going together. So if anybody would like to donate separate than what UMW will be given, that will be great. Okay. And you can see me at some point or over here.
Okay. And also, the Tuesday night Bible study will be starting this week at 6:30. Is that correct? 6:30 here at the in the education building. Any other announcements? Oh.
Thursday morning Bible study will be back at the education building.
Okay. Thursday morning Bible study at 10 a.m. will be over here as well on Thursday. Thank you to the Marcies for hosting us for the last few weeks. We appreciate that. Any others? Then let's begin our worship.
Thank you. Thank you, Jeff. Well, good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
Looks like we have sunshine. If you are able to, would you please stand for the call to worship? Call to the Lord who hears our prayers.
Sing to the Lord who delights in our songs.
Wait for the Lord, the source of our hope.
Worship the Lord who is worthy of our praise.
Let us pray. God of promise, Abraham scoffed and Sarah laughed when they were told of your plans for them and their family. Yet you remained faithful to your promise and gave them a son, Isaac. Help us to trust in your promise for our lives and to live according to your will. Amen. Please remain standing and we're going to sing hymn number 89 in our hymnals. First scripture this morning is from Mark chapter 10, verse 27. Jesus looked at them and said, "For mortals it is impossible, but not for God. For God all things are possible." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
And now it's time in our service for a passing of the peace of the Lord Jesus.
Peace be with you.
It's funny being up there. You know it. It is kind of funny.
It is. I never heard
of you. I know.
Man, no one in this group will potentially watch it.
I know.
Maybe not me.
It's a wonderful. Each pastor going to be a different level of
worship. It's been great. It's like everybody's built on the last person. It's great.
Y'all are usually past the piece a lot longer than this. This is so I don't see any children here today, so we'll go on and do joys and
concerns.
We're all children of God. Did you want to do a sermon for all of us? Okay. That's true. Some of us never will grow up. Are there any joys and concerns you'd like to share today? Let you know that Mel is in St. Johnsbury, and see John Page for exact information about where he is. Yes?
I have a concern, and I just got a text from a kid in the church. My brother-in-law, my husband's brother, has been getting worse and worse, and he's on hospice. He lives in Westbrook, and I don't think he has much time left. Just a prayer for Doug.
For Doug? Yes.
I would just like to recognize, I work for Sun River Health, which I work remotely. It was started by four women of color back in the early 70s that saw the need for health care for their people. And so they started opening clinics, and they now have almost 50 down in New York City, Long Island, the Hudson Valley, and they're one of the founding mothers passed this last week, and she was like a month shy of 90, and she was actually at another worker's funeral who had worked for many years, and she said, "I don't feel good." This was last week. She went to the hospital, she passed that night. I'd say that's not too bad, but I'm so proud to work for that company, and I get to see what they do. They have clinics for everyone. What can we do? And for the hardest tested people in the world, really. And
much trials and tribulations up there, but to see that moment when they were just as sweet as you can imagine, you know, it just makes it all worthwhile, you know, to have that moment up there. It's just those moments are few and far between, but it's, I just wanted to share that. It's,
thank you.
Yeah, you're welcome.
Yes.
I'd like prayers for Chris and Lloyd Steves. They have both had the COVID, and Chris just got a relapse.
Oh,
wow. So prayers for them.
For Chris and Lloyd, okay. Let us pray. Holy and loving God, we come to you this morning hearing stories of wonder and in small situations, but also hearing stories of sadness and grief and fear, stories of illness, stories of pain. It is so easy, O God, to focus on these negative things in our lives and not look around and see the beauty that is all around us and within us, because you are within us. Open our hearts, O God, to the possibilities that you lay before us. Open our eyes to see how this world could be if we live as you command us to live. Give us hope always, even in the midst of trials. Give us strength and courage, and give us love. We do, O God, pray for all these requests that were lifted up this morning. And we celebrate with the joys, and we know that in every situation you are involved. You are working in every life, everywhere. We just pray, O God, for healing, for comfort, for transformation. We pray for hope always. And in this time of such great political division in this country and so much violence around the world caused by wars, and we just pray, O God, for your peace and your love to unite us. Help us to stop demonizing those with whom we disagree, and help us to start loving those with whom we disagree, even if they do not love us back. But we trust, O God, that your love is powerful, and that your love can build bridges, and that your love can tear down walls, and that your love can open hearts and soften hearts, and that your love can inspire all of us to love as you command, so that your kingdom will come to earth, as your Son taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
The second scripture reading we have is from Genesis 18, 1 through 15, and 21, 1 through 7. The Lord Abraham appeared by the oaks of Mamre as he sat at the entrance of his tent in the heat of the day. He looked up and saw three men standing near him. When he saw them, he ran from the tent entrance to meet them, and he bowed down to the ground. He said, "My Lord, if I find favor with you, do not pass by your servant. Let a little water be brought, and wash your feet, and rest yourselves under the tree. Let me bring a little bread, that you may refresh yourselves, and after that you may pass on, since you have come to your servant." So they said, "Do as you have said." And Abraham hastened into the tent to Sarah, and he said, "Make ready quickly 3 measures of choice flour, knead it, and make cakes." Abraham ran to the herd and took a calf, tender and good, and gave it to the servant. He hastened to prepare it. Then he took curds and milk and the calf that he had prepared and set it before them, and he stood by them under the tree while they ate. They said to him, "Where's your wife, Sarah?" And he said, "There in the tent." Then one said, "I will surely return to you in due season, and your wife Sarah shall have a son." And Sarah was listening at the tent entrance behind him. Now Abraham and Sarah were old, advanced in age. It had ceased to be with Sarah after the manner of woman. So Sarah laughed to herself, saying, "After I have grown old and my husband is old, shall I have pleasure?" The Lord said to Abraham, "Why did Sarah laugh and say, 'Shall I indeed bear a child now that I am old?' Is anything too wonderful for the Lord? At the set time I will return to you in due season, and Sarah shall have a son." But Sarah denied, saying, "I did not laugh, but she was afraid." He said, "Oh, yes, you did laugh." The Lord dealt with Sarah as he had said, and the Lord did for Sarah as he had promised. Sarah conceived and bore Abraham a son in his old age, at the time of which God had spoken to him. Abraham gave the name Isaac to his son, whom Sarah bore him, and Abraham circumcised his son Isaac when he was 8 days old, as God had commanded him. Abraham was 100 years old when his son Isaac was born to him. Now Sarah said, "God has brought laughter for me. Everyone who hears will laugh with me." And she said, "Who would ever have said to Abraham and Sarah would nurse children? Yet I have borne him a son in his old age." The word of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
Would you please rise for the singing of the Gloria Patri? From Shine. You may be seated.
From
changing from glory to glory. Mirrored here, may our lives tell their story. Shine on me, shine on me. Shine, Jesus, shine. Fill this land with the Father's glory. Blaze, Spirit, blaze. Set our hearts on fire. Flow, river, flow. Flood the nations with grace and mercy. Send forth your word, Lord, and let there be light.
It had been over 2 decades, but it seemed like yesterday when Sarah thought about that day that Abraham came to her when they were living in the land where they had come from and told her that God had told him to pack up their things, to move to a new country that God would show them, and that God would make from them a great nation. They had so much hope. Well, she was probably a little skeptical. Well, she was a little skeptical at first because, you know, she was already getting kind of old. She had wanted a child since the day they were married, or since before they were married. She had waited so patiently, sometimes impatiently. And now they had this promise. With Abraham's enthusiasm, though, Sarah soon caught on and soon felt the joy he felt, and they started on their journey. I know that she thought that baby would come any day now. Any day. She would sit and wait in the mornings, wondering, trying to feel something deep within her to see if, to feel if something was happening within her, a new child, a new life, starting to take shape in her womb. But day after day, she felt nothing. Oh, there were some days that she felt something. She convinced herself that it was there, but it wasn't. I don't know how many times she had to work to build up that hope. How many times she was disappointed over the years. But time went on. They had many adventures. Their lives were good together. They had a great time. God had fulfilled so many of the promises, but the child still did not come. Finally, one day, in her desperation, she looked at her slave girl named Hagar, and she had an idea. She thought, well, maybe this promise that God made to Abraham was not for her as well. Maybe it was just for Abraham. So she gave her slave girl to Abraham. And much to her dismay, Hagar conceived almost immediately. And Hagar felt what was growing within her. And she was overjoyed with the life that was growing within her. And Sarah grew jealous. She grew so jealous that she started to treat Hagar like she had never treated her before, with great unkindness. So much unkindness that Hagar fled. She went into the wilderness until God told her to go back, that the child she was carrying would indeed be the father of a great nation. And so she went back and she endured Sarah's torment. Time went on. Hagar's child grew up. It'd been 13 years since Ishmael had been born. He was turning into a young man, and still Sarah had no child of her own. I don't think she believed that she would ever have a child at this point. And so when these three men came to Abraham, and told Abraham that within a year Sarah would have a child, her laughter was not a laughter filled with joy. It was a laughter filled with, I cannot bear this pain again. I cannot bear this hope again, only to be disappointed one more time because of a broken promise. For the promise seemed broken to her. She laughed, not out of joy, but to keep from crying, to keep from giving in to hope. It had taken her forever to be able to accept the fact that she would not have a child. And now God was making this promise again. I wonder how long it took before she really believed the promise had been fulfilled. How long before, or what signs in her body made her feel that God had truly answered this prayer that she had been praying since she was a young child? Maybe it was when she started to gain weight, when she just felt different. Maybe, I don't know what happened, but it did happen. And in time, she gave birth to the most wonderful child she could have ever imagined. It could have been any child that she had given birth to, but that would have given her the same kind of joy that she experienced on that day. It was a wonderful story. Truly a wonderful story of faith. Not so much Sarah's faith or even Abraham's faith, but God's faithfulness to the promise he made. It's a wonderful story that gives us hope. It inspires us. It's an inspiring story to encourage us to never give up that hope for something that we have longed for to come. And yet, I find this to be a terribly frustrating story as well. Because I imagine that every person in this room has prayed a prayer that God did not answer in the way we wanted God to answer. Something we longed for that we never received. Sometimes I think this story gives us false hope to believe that something will happen when it won't. The angel was right when he said that nothing is too wonderful for the Lord, but there are some wonderful things that God will not do. But I'm not here to dash all our hopes, to bring us down, to make us think that life isn't worth living even in the midst of our pain. Because I think that if we look around the room and know that everyone here has prayed a prayer that was not answered the way we wanted, or longed for something that was not received, if we pay attention to our lives and the world in which we live, we will find plenty of ways that God has blessed us, maybe not in the way we wanted, maybe not in the way we asked, but in ways that we never even thought we could believe. Sometimes it's in the smallest things, like a man reaching out his hand to a woman who had died and come back to life, and the way they looked at each other in just a moment. Sometimes it's the beauty of this changing season around us that we're about to experience, people keep telling me, in a couple of weeks. And I'm looking forward to it, even though there's some seasons after that that aren't as pleasant. But there's beauty in winter as well, just as there is beauty in the heat of summer. There is so much for which we can be grateful. So many blessings that God has granted us. So many dreams that we did not even dare to dream that have come true. So many hopes fulfilled. This story is not a story to tell us to always expect everything to happen the way a Hallmark movie always turns out. Because it doesn't happen that way. But there is always something to be grateful for in every situation in which we find ourselves. There is always a light shining in the darkness. There is always hope to be held on to. There is always something beautiful in the world. I think that is a story that we should, that is what God is telling me anyway, through this story that I have pondered about all my life, about the wonder that God performed in Sarah and in Abraham. And the wonder that God has performed in my life, maybe not as grand, and no one will write a story about my life that will last millennia, but the life I have lived is a life filled with God keeping the promise to care for me in every situation, to be with me in every situation, to let me know that I am not alone, even when I feel alone, to let me know that God is love, even when the world is filled with anything but love. There is beauty in this story, beauty that goes beyond the miraculous birth of Isaac. It's the beauty of a God who is faithful, who keeps promises, who abides with us, who cares for us, who loves us, and who will never forsake us. May we focus always on the faithfulness of God and remember that there truly is nothing too wonderful for the Lord. And the most wonderful thing of all is that God is with us. Amen. Our hymn of response today is "Tis So Sweet to Trust in Jesus," number 462. Please stand.
"Tis so sweet to trust in Jesus and to take him at his word, just to rest upon his promise and to know the saith the Lord, Jesus, Jesus, how I trust him, how I prove to him more and more, Jesus, Jesus, precious Jesus, oh, for grace to trust him more. Oh, how sweet to trust in Jesus, just to trust his cleansing blood, and in simple faith to plunge me beneath the healing cleansing flood. Jesus, Jesus, how I trust him, how I prove to him more and more. Jesus, Jesus, precious Jesus, oh, for grace to trust him more. Yes, 'tis sweet to trust in Jesus, just from sin and
be seated. It is now the time we talk about the offering. The offering plates are at the back of the sanctuary. Or if you are at home watching and would like to give, you can go to our website and give online, or you can mail us a check. The addresses of the three churches are on the screen. Let us pray. Holy and loving God, we give you thanks today that you have blessed us with so much. We give you thanks for your faithfulness to us. And we give you thanks for the gifts that have been given. We just pray that you will transform us, that you will transform this world through these gifts and us through the act of giving. Help us to always remember that you are with us and for us, and that you love everyone, and help us to do the same. We pray these things in Jesus' name. Amen. If there's anybody here or watching online would like to know what it means to be a follower of Jesus Christ, I would love to talk to you about what it means to be a follower. And if you'd like to be a member of this church, let me know. We'd love to have you come and join us in ministry here at North Haverhill or at Woodsville or Warren. So please let us stand and sing. Our hymn of commitment, this might be a new one to you, but it's real easy. Joy in the Morning. It's the last song in the faith we sing.
Christ on the tongue of everyone who speaks of you. Amen.
Amen. Amen.